If you look at it, COVID-19 is a pandemic. So the issue is, what I hear from people, when the pandemic spread to Malaysia, the first step is to control. So the measures that the companies took is to control. Now, when you want to introduce controls, they are guided by the government measures and what is the rules, etc. So the first step they did is at the workplace, create social distancing, and then segregate the team. They divided the team into team A, team B. So, and then rostering them, and then you implement this. How do you prevent this pandemic from spreading? So they have to ensure and keep current with the information, what's happening. So you find that the multinationals are able to have experience shared for the other operations, other parts of the world. So they are able to handle it because they have the experience. They have the sharing done. So you find, number one. Number two is business. If you do business, we are looking at profits. And during this period, it's not profits. We're talking about sustainability of the business. So how do you sustain the business? How do you take a balance between business and also employment? And you find that they are able to sustain for a longer period and prevent this unemployment and retrenchment. Whereas the non-multinationals have a different issue. So what I'm trying to say is, it's just controls. The controls are more strict in a multinational because of sharing of experience on a global basis. Plus, they have the luxury to do that. So the pandemic needs to be controlled. So what effective controlling measures we take, all the measures you take. But at the same time, you have to come with innovative practices. We cannot depend on old practices to say that business will come back as usual and we'll go back to do as usual. What you have to do is, we have to find out how can we overcome with this pandemic, how can we manage our business effectively? What alternatives do we have? So we have to look at alternatives in these challenges. So it's a challenging time. But while we are talking about a challenging time, there are some industries which are gaining. If you look at the papers, see, you know, industries that are making gloves, pharmaceutical companies, which I'm taking, you find, you go to the pharmacy, you see a lot of people going for medicines. They want to buy vitamins. So there are some industries gaining. But at the same time, there are other export industries which are losing. But this is life. But how are you going to challenge this? What are you going to do? So there's no definite answers to overcome these challenges. If you depend on old formulas, you will never get an answer. But now, what are the new formulas? Who is going to devise a new formula? Who's going to design a new formula? So it all comes with your own practices. You look at your own industry. What is the best you can do to look at an alternative? Like colleges, they can go for distance learning, e-learning, etc. By industries, what can you do? Can you outsource things? What is that? There must be a way, and we must find a way for it. That's what I would say. Innovation is the pathway to the future. So we can't depend on old measures. We have to look for new measures. Now, what is the new measures that have been done? The industries are very diverse. So in a panel forum like that, we cannot give an answer. A general answer is, find new methods of operating. Get your business sustained. That's the only answer. Whether multinational, SME, single operator, own business, take the smallest business. The guy who's running a retail shop, he still have to survive. You see, if you take an individual who's surviving in his family, he will run the shop. He's a single owner. He arranges somehow to do the business and he attracts the customers. So when it comes to survival, you will find a way to survive. But if you don't fight for survival, you just want to say and say things will change. Let us let change to come slowly. It will never come. So the panel is unanimous in that. Fight the war pandemic. Let's sustain the business. How you want to do it yourself. Find your way. There is a way. Like, for example, airlines. You look at Taiwan. They say flight nowhere. Just people want to, I mean, you want to create a new experience. I mean, innovative, fly nowhere. Right? You just want to fly in the air and come back. And Singapore Airlines want to do that. But then now, after this pandemic, they stall it. So that's a new idea. But that's in the airline. What about the other food industry, etc.? So sustainability of the business can be done if you find new ways, like innovative ways. So we can't say, like, for example, in an institute like us, where we have products, we just find how do we take this product in a different format. If the product is still valuable and people want the products, then you can channel it in a different manner. That's what the views are, basically. Innovative practices has to be done immediately from now. The government is giving initiatives to SMEs and industries. The government plays its own role. They are playing an effective role. But in this pandemic, it's not one person to play the role. Everyone have to play a role. Every individual, even individuals walking in the street, they have to play a role, ensure that they take all the safety measures. The pandemic can be controlled if everybody take the measures. So business and live life is two different things. You live a normal life, make sure you take the measures strictly. Why does the government want to impose fines and all that? Because we know people are relaxed. You have to force through. So similarly, in business, we have to force through ourselves to make the change. The government is doing what it can do best. If you ask me whether online learning is effective or not, it depends on the method. It depends on the method, how you design the program. Because generally I hear people say, you can't do the program, you know, for long hours. But we have designed digital learning, which is 2 full days. But we do it 8 hours, 8 hours. But we take an interval. So 1 day, 8 hours. Next week, another 8 hours. But how do you keep the 8 hours engaged? I compare today, I had a face-to-face class. No, face-to-face class and an online learning. With your face mask, everybody is a public program. So they come, we have a different audience from different areas. They all wear the face mask. You only see the eyes. So I talk to the eyes only, not to the face. We don't know how the face looks like. So you talk, you feel whether you are engaged or not engaged, whether you're smiling or not smiling, you don't know. Only the eyes you see. And then, whereas online learning, you can see them. You see them, and then you ask, like professor said, put quiz, put questions, and then put them into a discussion group. So it depends on your format. So if it is just, I went for some online learning, they just a lecture, put the notes, lecture, 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 then of course, the delivery is not effective. So you can make it effective. It is not online learning that is not effective. It is the delivery, the method you use, the operation, how you get the subject matter is all total. There is no difference between face-to-face and online learning. If you do it right, that's what I feel. Otherwise, from experience, I enjoy doing online learning rather than face-to-face. There's a question there. Are we really ready to work from home? How do we measure the productivity? Really, we are not prepared to work from home. But the situation has caused us to work from home. So because of the situation, we don't have measures to measure productivity. All our system are measuring productivity at the workplace, not working from home. So it is only, if we really going to make it a long term, if the industry is going to say, okay, it will reduce my cost if I have some people working from home, basically, you're outsourcing the work. Working from home is an outsource. This outsource work is a contract for service rather than a contract of service. So here is a temporary measure. If you are going to have a permanent measure, then you have to change the nature of the service. Now there's another question. Has SOCSO amended to cover the accident at home? Now this is an interesting question, because SOCSO coverage is for coming to work at workplace and going back to work, back home. And then you're talking about accident at workplace during the working hours. At workplace, the management can be responsible for the measures to ensure there is safety measures in the company. But at home, how can the management ensure you're at home very safe? It may just make a coffee and spill over you. There may be injury. So our laws have not been extended to that areas and all that. So maybe a case comes up, a rare case comes up and goes to SOCSO, appeal, and politicians get involved, then they become aware, maybe they would consider that, but until then, there's no coverage. So now, there was another question asked. SOCSO coverage is okay. What about insurance? The companies have insurance for the employees. Does that insurance cover at home? Now that you have to check with the insurance company. And this is what we tell as part of procedure. We don't tell our employees what is the coverage for you. We just take the measure, work from home, that's all. We don't look at all the other things involved in it, because it's all a temporary measure. This is out of the picture. We talk about out of the context. If you look at this issue, actually, it's a global issue. This issue of pandemic, COVID-19, is a global issue. Globally, the leaders come to a right mind, the right order, then it will be corrected. The problem is a global leadership problem, because we are living in a whole economic theory of competition. We want business competition. Countries want to compete with each other. They want to control each other. So if the leadership at a global level don't see a sustainable business, they must think of sustainability and cooperation. Seeing the world as one, unless or until they see as that one, is very difficult to manage anything. Because when big nations start fighting, the small nations will suffer.